Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Miller Lite NASCAR Cup Series, race 15 of the 26 race regular season. I am joined in the booth by Cater Johns. How you doing?
Doing pretty great, if I say so myself. I love Chicago. Last time we were here in the prior season, it was a night race. Things got pretty hectic in the running order, but the racing was amazing. And in the end, was the right person in victory lane. Yeah, woo.
Wow, that's pretty biased. But anyway, we're going to go trackside for the command. Cars roll off. Caden Bishop is on the pole. First pole of the season. He's looking for his third win of the season. We'll introduce you to the rest of the grid coming right up. Caden Bishop, Kylie Greider are front row here. What are these guys going to have to deal with today as far as the Chicagoland Speedway goes?
I would probably go with just racing side by side. It's a multi-groove racetrack. They're going to have to adapt with racing around each other. Aches with how the air behaves around the cars when you're side by side, three wide, perhaps even four wide. So I think that'll be the main thing to watch as these guys race each other here at Chicago today.
Pace car pulling off. We're coming into the Geico restart zone to take the green flag for the Chicago 400. Right away, Caden Bishop off to a huge start. Top four is going to single file out. Bishop, Ethan O'Connor, Kylie Greider flying back to third, and then JD is going to pull up into fourth place, side by side behind this group.
I think you definitely need to watch today is that Dollar General number five car. Very odd to see him in those colors, but JD Bregler, as the entire team, Hosemann Motorsports, has been doing the scheme swaps pretty much. Here comes Ethan O'Connor to the inside for the lead as Caden led lap one.
O'Connor looking to the inside. This guy has looked like a totally different driver ever since we went and made two road course stops at Sebring and Sonoma. This car was languishing much of the time as a back marker for the beginning of the season after the Daytona 500. But in those two races, he was fairly competitive, running top 10 in both races. And now he also showed great speed at Charlotte. And now he's running in second here at Chicago.
G making his way up to fourth in the draft of the 09 car. Ethan O'Connor had to settle back into second place there as he couldn't quite make the pass on the inside of the one of Caden Bishop in that Juice WRLD machine. Carter Jones now looking to get into the top five inside of his teammate in the five, that being JD Bregler. And as I was speaking about JD Bregler earlier, he's just had so much misfortunes to start out this season, the first 13, 14 races. Here we are, race 15, and JD's got to make something happen eventually. But it looked like as he was trying to make ground, he eventually got caught up on the high side. Now just trying to get settled back in line, but Carter's not allowing that to happen.
But that's the beauty of Chicagoland, is the multiple grooves. In and many other tracks, JD would be dead to rights right now, getting freight train. Here at Chicago, he's got a fighting chance to stay right where he is.
He's sliding up just a bit. Will that allow Carter to get the run on him down the back? Looks as though he might have the advantage. Gets the nose underneath the 04 right here. And here comes Dylan as well.
Dylan Jones following. Oh, he looks up. Might have pushed a little arrow tight right there. Here comes to the 5 to try to get the 62 back, but he's going to just slot in line instead. The double zero now to the outside of the 48.
Over to the back of the 5. He is all over him. And Caden Bishop continuing to hold the lead over the 59 of Ethan O'Connor right now as they enter turn 3 again.
And the 04 is looking for third place. Giancarlo Urenda, he had a very consistent start to the season, three straight top five finishes in the second, third, and fourth races, and then winning at Denver. But he's just been very inconsistent since then, not picking up very many top tens in the span since.
I mean, that'll happen, especially in a long season like this. You get on a hot streak, you're clicking off top fives, get that elusive win. I think that was probably Big G's second win of his career. First of the season, as you mentioned. But once you go on a downward spiral, it just continues and continues, and it seems like you never can get out of it. But all it takes is one good finish, and then eventually you find yourself climbing back out of that hole. So we'll see if Big G can do that here today as he's in the top three.
Taking a look here further back in the pack at some contenders that are stuck towards the back of the field. Here we're looking at KR as he battles side by side with Brandon Allen. Allen currently in the playoffs. KR just basically racing for wins. Looking to the inside here, and Brandon Allen's going to get a monster run off the top.
And what I've noticed from Brandon Allen so far this season, what's kept him in the playoff picture despite not winning anything, is his consistency that he lacked in season one that got him in lots of trouble at places like Denver in season one and stuff like that, getting in just such stupidly violent wrecks, it seemed like, all the time. But now Allen just coming into his own, really just settling in here, just trying to gather points week in, week out, and so far it's working.
He was one of the guys that when the races got longer, we were worried this guy might not make it, but he's adjusted pretty well. Currently inside the playoffs, as we mentioned. Here's Tanner Campos, and this guy needs something good to happen to him.
For sure. Tanner, I mean, he is the epitome of misfortune. I mean, recount the amount of times, not just in this series, but other series. We've seen in the Dirt series, the Truck series, he's had multiple misfortunes. Really good fortune in the Truck series to Dover. I'll give him that, but I mean, aside from the few wins he's gotten, which obviously are highlights for him, I mean, outweighed by just all the chokes, all the bad luck that he's had. Imagine how much success Tanner Campos would have if he didn't get involved in so much wrecks that were really out of his control.
Speaking of out of his control, Ethan O'Connor is not in control of the speed of the 04 and the 62. They're through to second and third, and they are posting the fastest laps on the track right now.
Jones respects Big G as a driver. I mean, who doesn't, honestly? And it appears as though those two have been working together pretty well. They've been helping push each other through the straightaways and stuff, giving each other the boosts down the back, down the front, and make the moves on Kylie Greider and Ethan O'Connor. And now they race side by side. Carter Jones flexing some muscle on the top line.
Carter Jones trying to whip around the 04. This is the best the 62 has looked since last season. Haven't really seen speed like this in any race of the 62 this year, other than maybe South Boston. But here they are right now in one of the races they're the defending winners of, and they have showed up.
He matches up against this one car of Caden Bishop, though. I think Caden Bishop right now has been the favorite for the entire season, honestly. He's been front-running, having the speed, leading the laps. I think this can be a true challenge for the 62 to see if he's got that speed back from season one that he had.
Here we're looking back at the lap cars because there is an absolute mess in the mid-pack area. Alan Mooch all the way up against the wall running the Larson line. A lot of contenders back here with wins. Kyler Scott, Logan Speed, Justin Ricci, Raven Dagan. A lot of guys that are in contention for the championship that aren't running that well so far.
Yeah, especially Justin Ricci mired back here. He just came off that win at the Coca-Cola 600 at Charlotte and just been mired back here. When you're in dirty air, it's really, really difficult to make any move. We talk about Chicago being a multi-group racetrack, but your car's got to be able to have the speed and the handling to run the outside line like Carter Jones has been doing and succeeding at. It doesn't look like Justin Ricci wants to get off the bottom.
Ricci currently P25, really struggling with getting around these other cars. And here we're looking at Dontavius Young just outside the top 10. This gnarly mess of cars right behind Tanner Campos.
Great win earlier in the season. Probably one of the favorite wins of the season, if we're being honest. And KR making a move here. Trying to hold off Trevor Davidson as well. See if he can get anything going on the 22 of Brian Logano as well.
There's the 15, Caleb Marinelli, who started around... He started in the low teens. He's worked his way up into the top 15 here. Pretty solid run for the 15 that we're getting used to, although not quite the speed we saw from him at Charlotte last week.
Yeah, I mean, Caleb, we've seen when he has flashes of speed, he is very speedy. We saw it at Atlanta, just pure domination out of that 15, that Pepsi machine. He knows how to front run, but as you see up front here, Caden Bishop has fallen back to third, Big G up to second, and Carter Jones has taken the lead away.
We were wondering how the 62 would match up to the 1. Looks like he's more than a match for the 1 as he's taken the lead now. Now built up a 0.35 second lead over Big G. Caden Bishop is now half a second back. Ethan O'Connor remains in the top 5, so does Kylie Greider. JD Bregler right behind them, trying to make up some ground. Halfway in the stage.
Caden trying to get back at the 04, really sends it.
Whoa!
Like out of desperation. Trying to get something out of this race car. I don't think that's the way he should be going about it. I mean, at this point, it seems like he's been pushing this car pretty hard to its limit. Adjustments to that one car if they're going to get any speed out of it.
You're on board with Big G and the caution's out. Caution out on the speedway. The smoke in turn two.
One and two. Yeah.
Caden, this is going to give Caden Bishop a chance to reset here. With the way he was driving, that's just something that comes with Caden. He is, as far as his driving style, the most aggressive driver on track. He drives into the corner deeper than just about everybody. Doesn't really roll that well, but he smashes the gas, and it's a lot of tracks it works really well for him. Kind of like a Tyler Reddick type of driver.
I just Tyler Reddick, so I mean, I think that's where he might get that from. At other tracks, it helps him a lot, like you said. I mean, it's what's got him two wins this year, including the Daytona 500. But other tracks like this, you saw there, just not working. And eventually, you just got to limit yourself, you know? Don't push beyond what the car is capable of, as now we go here for pit stops under the caution.
The cars that were that looked like they were involved in the wreck were the 26 and the 78, who are running in the top 15. So that's a real tough break for teams having solid starts. Carter Jones now pulling out of the pits. Let's see if he can get off pit road first. He does. Caden's
gaining a spot.
Caden beats Big G out of pit road. Kylie gains a spot. Tanner gains a bunch of spots. Field coming off pit road. We're going to take a look at what happened here real quick. So we got the 26 and the 7. Oh,
that's a big hit.
That's a mess.
Looked to me like the 78 had issues entering the corner, missed his mark maybe. The 26 was on his bumper.
Here's what it...
No, the 26 came down, it looked like.
He must... when I'm out, that's not normal for Allen. That he must have thought he was clear.
Yeah, I think that right there, that was just a misjudgment on the 26. Pretty bad misjudgment. Seeing this with like on straightaways, like try to pull in behind a guy, and you're not clear, but entering the corner, that's a pretty poor misjudgment by Alan Mooch to turn someone head on into the wall like that this early into the race.
Tough break for Seth Peters too, who is trying to get into the top 10 in points, just not having anything go his way recently. And yeah, there it is. They just got hooked.
I don't know if he was thinking like Seth was going to take the low line, like painted against the white, but no, I mean, that was just 26 is part.
Real,
barely getting by there.
Yeah, these guys are, they have to race a bit too hard for my liking. Like, they have to race back to the line. It's just, it's not a great rule. I wish they would change it, but you know, it's the MLNCS officials. They don't give a shit.
They don't. They never have. But that's just the charm of it all, you know?
What you call charm, I call Tom Larson.
What?
This broadcast booth has just been canceled.
Freaking Tom Larson. Oh, Lord. That's a throwback.
That's a serious throwback. That was like 2 years ago. Wow.
Completely forgotten about Tom Larson. Yeah, how was that 2 years ago? How was it 2 years ago that you were like, hey, man, I need you to commentate this good old MLNCS race. It was the second race in its history. And I was there with my peace tea. I think I almost spilled it or something like that. Yeah, I spilled it on my shirt. It was unfortunate, but it was a really good day.
It was a great day other than Tom Larson dying. That part wasn't fun, but
That part was unfortunate, but like Matthew Idle winning that terrible wreck with Roden and others. I mean, it's just iconic, and the legacy continues here. Season 2, Chicago. I mean, MLNCS is thriving better than ever.
Hell yeah. Lights are off on the pace car, so it's going to be pulling in this time by Carter Jones, Caden Bishop, Giancarlo Urenda, Kylie Grider, and Ethan O'Connor are your top five. Then Bregler, Campos, Dover, Davidson, and Taddy are your top 10 as Carter takes the green flag and gets a massive jump.
Massive jump. Caught everyone off guard behind him. Going too wide, double file, peeking to the inside. Trevor Davidson behind him. It is KR to the inside of Evan Toddy. Here comes the 04 of Urenda. Tucks back in line behind the 1 of Caden Bishop as Grider goes low of the 04.
Grider to the inside. JD looks to the inside of Ethan O'Connor. Nothing doing, but his teammate Tanner's not going to do anything so he can get back in a rhythm. Caleb Marinelli around the outside three wide looking for stage points.
Can go in the stage. O'Connor all over the 09 right here as they exit turn two. Gives her room as the 04 uses the high line to get back around in third place. Here comes Tanner Campos.
Oh, they're going to dive in three wide. Tanner sliding up the track. Oh, that could have been
really tight.
That was tight. O'Connor stayed in the gas and is able to hold them off. JD now trying to hold off the double zero. Doesn't look like he'll be able to. Tanner's going to slide gently up in front of him.
It's really tight when you're three, almost four wide off turn two and turn four especially. Things tighten up faster than these drivers expect with how just like, it seems like the turn race is pretty constant through the whole turn one and two and then turn three and four, but it just sharpens up just a bit on corner exit and it catches drivers off guard sometimes and sometimes creates a pretty bad wreck.
Caleb Marinelli now to the inside of Evan Taddy. That's for 10th spot. That will be stage points if he can get there, but he can't. Taddy up high though. That's going to give Caleb a chance. He rides up the track trying to get the side draft. Doesn't look like he'll be able to get the 89 this time. He's still there though. Oh, Brian!
Oh. Brian to the inside almost. Oh, he is
big,
there.
That's all. Big crossover. Caleb now dead even with the 89. JD falling back.
I'm seeing Ricci back here, still mired back in traffic. He might be up to almost the top 20 by now. But
Contact made!
Oh my lord!
They're both going to keep it going.
Marinelli. Wow.
Not a lot of damage to either car.
It's into the inside of Bragler.
Davidson looking
sliding
for
the up. Sliding.
He is tight. That almost gave Caleb the room, but Caleb did not do anything with him. He just went back in line. A lot of
right
on the bumper.
Behind the wheel of the 15 as he knows he needs as much stage points as he can possibly nab here in this next nine laps.
Caleb not giving Trevor Davidson a lot of respect is up front. Caden has gotten to second. Giancarlo Arenda falls back to fourth now. And Tanner Campos looks for a top five spot.
This battle actually between the double zero and 59. O'Connor's been holding a nice line up high, and he's been contending with Tanner every lap. But now it looks as though Tanner's finally got the job done on the 59, and he advances into the top five. Colin Dover also looking to perhaps advance up to sixth. Oh,
just a little bit of a slide job, almost side by side for the lead, as Caden now wants this stage win from Carter. He's going to look high.
Caden Bishop will not go down without a fight. That's just how he is. He's in the draft of the 62. Also in the draft of the 1 is the 09 of Kylie Greider and Big G in 4th.
I have a feeling that any state agent that involves Caden Bishop is going to be pretty spectacular as we come to 6 to go in the stage. Here he comes to the inside.
Inside. Oh, he did exactly what he did prior to pit stops right there. Kind of dives in.
But that
get speed off the corner.
But that time the maneuver worked a little better.
I'll give him that. He is really pushing this car to the limits on entry. He's trying to maximize the speed he gets into the corner entry. And right there it seemed to work pretty well because now he's right on him again.
Kylie. Caden turns down underneath the 62, but just can't get the run to get underneath him.
Tanner's in the battle now. He's right in the wake of Big G.
Here's the onboard with Caden Bishop. Carter gets a big jump off the corner. Caden getting tight in the wake. Now way up high, up into that top groove. Big run down the backstretch.
Yup, let's see where he goes with it.
A lane, half a lane.
Just a lane higher, yeah.
And another big run. To the inside.
62 blocks him.
Big block. Back to the bottom. He's getting tight in the wake. He just can't stay in the throttle the way he wants to when Carter cuts him off like that. That's all Carter really has to do. He has to find a way to get in the one's lane as the 09 looks below again. If he just keeps finding a way to get in the one's path and arrow block and take the arrow away, he can hold him off for this stage win, but he's got to be able to do that as he's not doing it this time. The one way up high.
Allow Kylie Greider to move up to second here. I don't know what it is between Greider and Carter Jones, but they are always involved in battles for wins, stage wins. There was like three or four different instances in season one, like Daytona. What was that one short track in the playoffs? Battling, but now she's falling back as Tanner gives a push to the one of Caden Bishop on the high line, and Big G bring it into the battle.
Final lap, stage one. They're gonna train Kylie on the outside. Does Tanner have anything for Caden Bishop? No, he does not. But there is no challenge to Carter Jones. And as they come off the final turn, Carter Jones with an impressive drive, he is gonna win stage one.
Not expecting that. It looked like Carter was holding up the entire top five right there, but so far, he's using the air to his advantage. I mentioned at the top of the show how air was going to be possibly the critical factor here at Chicago, learning how to utilize it, learning how to adapt to the cars around you, keep your car stable. And dirty air has been just massive factor in this race so far. It's now sixth place. Colin Dover is up in the mix. Caden to the high line.
To the outside. Carter was not able to block him this time. Drag race down the backstretch.
Bishop was like, you know what? You won't give me low? Oh, Carter washes up a tad.
And that's
you won't give me the low side? I'll take the high line.
And he takes the high line to perfection. Caden Bishop back out front at Chicago.
Guys are going to be wanting to get around the 62.
Way up the track. Slower.
Yeah, the 62 has lost quite a bit of speed, it appears. Tanner making the move to the inside. We'll see if Greider and Big G follow. Colin Dover's fallen back just a bit, but he's hanging in there.
And now three wide behind them, back in the field. Carter Jones losing a bit of ground to the one. We're going to take a look back at this battle. It's the same group. Toddy, Logano, Marinelli.
You see, very quietly, just lingering, 8th place J.D. Bregler. I feel like somehow, someway, he may become a contender later this race. But right now, just safe, and they're going to work on improving the adjustments of that 5 car as the race goes on.
We're going to take a look here. We're going to see the different lines that these guys are running. See, here's Carter, a lane up. He's going to get a big run on Caden that way. Looks to the inside, nothing there. Now he goes to the inside. Caden up top. Tanner's going to turn down underneath him. Let's see if he can do something.
Maybe he could give his teammate a push right here.
He's trying, but Caden, with the run off the top, is still going to get a big run. Now they're all going to be a lane up because of the wake of the 2 car.
Watch this right here. Let's see if anything amounts to this. And the lap traffic right in front of Caden. Who was that?
That is the two of Brian Leon.
Ooh,
Caden to the inside. Tanner shoves his way to the top. But that might have been a bit of a mistake in calculation by the
Greider
double zero.
Using Tanner as a pick right here, or the last car as a pick on Tanner.
Leon.
It's the middle three wide.
What a move. Tanner Campos trying to hold on to third. Leon gets out of the way. Good work by the lap car to not affect the leaders too much.
Carter Jones has done what Caden Bishop's been doing this race, just diving it in, kind of giving him a little spook.
Now you see, oh, Kylie. Oh, she's going to... Tanner washes up the track trying to give her room. They're able to hold position.
Dover back there. He's got speed. He caught up to these guys. Now he's passing Big G on the inside for fifth.
Dover has been one of the fastest cars all day. Tanner a lane up again. Seems like the bottom lane is the best lane around the track, but if you have the wake of a car in front of you, you want to be more up top. You definitely don't want to be following them.
Yeah, it seems like being one lane, almost a half lane higher than a car glued to the bottom, it's probably your best bet for trying to pass someone. Unless your car works very well up top. I haven't seen much cases of that today, but it seems like the best way to pass is doing one of those two.
The top line is a really good defensive line, though, it seems. Here's Tanner trying to make it work. Not quite the
racetracks like this. You can just change whatever to whatever line you want, low, middle, half a lane up, high. And when you're the leader, you get to control the air, so you can just make second place predict where you're going to go.
Caden Bishop's been pretty predictable since he's gotten the lead, though. He's been going to the bottom. Carter's been largely following him. Tanner up high again. Kylie's going to run a lane lower, but still up high. Let's see what kind of run this double zero gets. He's going to go a lane up. No run for him. Oh, he's got the draft. Here he comes.
Work together. No, I'm just kidding. Tanner looked like he wanted to show the nose to the inside of the 62. Like, hey, buddy, I'm here. I might make a move on you in a lap or two.
Now battle just outside the top 10. Here's Justin Ricci now. Another update on the 12. As he's continuing to work through the field. He's up into P17. So he's slowly but surely getting his way up there. Whenever he has room to breathe, he's got a top 10 car. It's just he's stuck in all this dirty air, and it's just not really helping his case. As you see the field fly by here.
Fireball Motorsports has lots of good equipment, but they haven't really shown up much today, and that's because of the product of dirty air. I mean, none of them are in the top 10 right now, and that's an absolute shock in my eyes.
Tanner way up the track again. This time Carter's following him up a bit. I don't know if Carter's not comfortable, but he's not getting as high as the double zero is.
Massive run, cross over to the inside, down the back into turn three. Tanner Campos, can he make it work? I don't know, that defensive line by the 62 is going to hold him off, it looks like, unless he can stay there to the quarter panel on the inside.
Can't get there. Tanner going up high again. He loses so much ground in the middle of the corner that it almost negates the run he has off the turn. That's what the 62 is really doing better than him that's making it so hard to pass, is that the 62 rolls better.
That. Still hanging with this top four. Colin Dover's falling back a bit. Tanner tries again to the inside of the 62, and this time he's going to make it work.
That time Tanner got the runoff. Not quite
done. Carter trying to hang with him.
Not quite done yet.
Oh, now he's got the push from the 09 of Kylie Greider.
Where does the 09 go? She goes to the bottom with Tanner. Tanner's gonna clear Carter for the position. Maybe no. Oh, it's close. Not able to do it.
Upper. There. Oh,
and Kylie right on the back bumper.
Third place. She thought her best bet was to push Tanner Campos through and pass Carter Jones, but Jones is able to retain the spot. I think Kylie's like, okay, you're the slow one. Now she's trying to get around the double zero.
Oh, Carter loses it off the turn. I don't know what happened there, but it's going to give Tanner another run at him.
Double zero. They're pretty equal right now.
And Kylie's going to slingshot around Grider him. With the run. Kylie Grider up to third. She has, this has been a revelation race for the 09. This is the best we've seen her consistently across an entire race. We've seen her sort of struggle in the middle of a race and find the top five. We've seen her have speed early and then not get the finish she deserved. Obviously, we haven't gotten to the finish yet, but this is the best she's looked consistently all day. Consistently been a top three or four car.
Not only for the 09, but also the 62. I mean, remember last time we were here at Chicago, it was the 62 and the 36, then 36 of Kylie Grider that battled for the win. Now they're back at a track they're comfortable at. They clearly have the speed to compete for the win again. And now they're just up against Caden Bishop to see if they can try and grab the win away from him.
Here's a real fun battle. 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. Trevor Davidson, Evan Taddy, Kyler Scott, and Tree Schlasser Jr. Taddy to the bottom.
Right here has had a breakout season. Two wins so far. Now to the inside of Davidson. Kyler Scott's going to
get what a slingshot
to the high side. It looks like Evan Taddy had to check up there, actually. He got tight. That also allows Tree Schlasser Jr. to move to the high side, making the 11. But now he's down low, and they're both around the 89 of Evan Taddy now.
Tree Schlasser, this guy, this is really a revelation race for him. You know, he was tapped to replace Marco Suarez in that car after Marco was basically just bad, and then he had no expectations going in. That was not a car that was expected to compete for much. And he really has been silent much of the season, but this is his first real great race.
A bit of noise. I would like to see him crack into the top 10, though. That'd be pretty cool. And he's not far from doing it. You see Kyler Scott in 10th right now. That is really close with a lapped car right there.
Kylie Grider giving Nick Nelson no room. Tanner Campos is going to try to follow through. That's the thing with Kylie, much like Caden Bishop, one of the most aggressive drivers in the field. Not aggressive in the same ways as Caden, but she will sneak up on you. Oh my god, Tanner. Tanner giving her a taste of her own medicine. That was close right there. That could have been big.
It could have been big. I mean, when you're getting that close to someone with the way the air has acted on these cars today at Chicago, really any intermediate track, you can get a person loose or even get into them real easily. And before you know it, it's a crash. So.
And these cars at this point in the run are really struggling. They've lost about 3 seconds from where they were at the start of this run. And this top line is getting better and better, and it's getting harder and harder to pass. And I'm sure Tanner is getting more and more frustrated as people are taking advantage of him trying to make something happen.
Oh, in the current stage, it appears Tanner up a lane from Grider, see if he can get a run down the back.
Not really much he can do there. Tanner Campos just continuing to hound this 09. Oh, he looks to the bottom. She gives him the bottom.
See, the Highline has looked real good in turns one and two, though, and it looks as though...
Tanner's sliding up. Oh, he's. I think he's going to stay with her. Not quite.
The point where aggravation sets in. You're halfway through the race just now at this point, and you're thinking, man, I just need this one spot. Maybe I can contend with the top two, but Tanner just can't quite do it.
And they're coming to... And this is now 12 laps to go in the stage. So it's not just, oh, I can contend. It's, I need to get around her right now if I want to win this stage. And just not able to do it.
Right now, it's just these four right now. Dover has fallen back, over a second back from this current pack of four cars. Brian Logano up to sixth. Big G has been passed for sixth by Logano. He's currently in seventh. He's dropped off on speed quite a while, but quite a bit.
This battle for the lead continuing to heat up. There's eighth and ninth, Scott and Ethan O'Connor. Refreshing to see Kyler Scott up here again, as here comes Tree Schlosser. He's looking for stage points.
Just one spot shy at the moment. Trevor Davidson occupying the 10th and final spot.
His teammate.
Stage points.
His team. That's who he's got to catch. Oh, he's Davidson having trouble with Nick Nelson right now.
That's Tree Schlosser's best bet is for the 45 to get stuck trying to pass the 37.
He's still having trouble, can't get it around him, slides up the track a little bit, trying to force the 37 up, and that's exactly what he does. Patrice Lasser is going to have a run on him, becoming a 9 to go in the stage.
The best that could have worked.
Three wide.
Patrice Lasser. Not only did he, he's sliding up a bit.
Oh,
Katie
big run.
Highline work.
Oh, in the wall.
He may have gotten into the wall, yeah.
Really hard battle with Patrick Rode and Ethan Farley, who have worked their way into the top 15. JD also sees those stage points in front of him. He wants to go get them.
Quite a distance to go, though. About a second behind Trevor Davidson right now. Toddy up high as well now.
Toddy's fallen back. Here's Roden back to the inside.
He's been falling back a bit. Hasn't been able to get the speed he wants out of this car. He's outside the top 15. He's side by side with Justin Ricci as we speak, actually.
That's 4 feet. Oh, contact made. Roden. Farley and Roden. JD trying to get the run on Nick Nelson. They're in the wall.
Oh.
Roden with damage. Contact with two other cars. Nelson spins backwards and the caution comes out.
Oh my god. You know, you had a feeling that Nick Nelson was just holding these guys up a bit much. Holy crap, guys. Look out.
That was a...
You had a feeling that... My god.
That was only a matter of time.
Aggressive guys were racing Nick Nelson, and now this sets up a shootout for the second stage points, and this should be some.
This is gonna be interesting. Massive damage to the 15 right there. That team's gonna have to work on that during the caution.
A day to forget for Marinelli at this point, as now. Caden Bishop had a great pit stop that got him a spot early on, so we'll see if he can maintain the lead off pit road.
Everyone is coming down, not entirely surprising. There's Jones and Campos getting into their stalls. Bishop, Grider.
Strategy? I don't think so with how long this run has been, but you never know. It's for stage points. You saw Ricci.
Oh, there's some strategy. O'Connor out first. Ricci's going to come out second. General Jake. Oh, he gets him. He comes out third.
and Bishop will be on the high line restarting fourth. This will be fun.
Three cars took two tires. Oh, contact with the 94 and the 5.
My thing. Just cosmetic damage.
They might have to come back down pit road to repair that, though. Here's what happened between the 5 and the 37.
Oh, man. You see, JD's been working that high line so well, but Nick Nelson just got to respect the lead lap cars more than what he was doing there. Just didn't give the 5 the lane.
He knew that the 5 was there and he was out of the way and got in the way. I don't understand what his thought process was there, like, at all. There's Paul Tomlin missing it by inches. And then two cards.
Football team fan, huh?
Here's JD running that high line, running the Larson line. Gets a huge run. I don't know if Nick Nelson just didn't know it was coming, or even if he didn't know JD was there, he should have still given him the room. He's a lap car. He's not racing anybody.
It didn't look like it was blatant, I'll say that. I mean, JD had such a big run. One of the bigger runs we've seen all day.
Oh!
You see it right here.
There's contact with the 8 and the 23, but that has nothing to do with this wreck.
Didn't look damaged. The 15 got damaged, as you mentioned. And just look at this view.
Being told the 15 got it from ramming the 89. So be on the lookout for Evan Toddy to possibly have some damage. Here it is from Roden. Ooh. I mean, I could say he should have been down a lane, but he really shouldn't have been in that kind of position anyway. Nick Nelson should not have come up the track right there. Here it is from Ricci.
Ricci, likewise with Caleb, has just been kind of mocked back. He misses it. Incredible job.
Completely blinded by the smoke, and he finds his way through. Oh, Brandon Allen. Whoa. Ricci's in the wall a little bit.
He tapped the wall. Yeah.
All right, so we're going to have two laps to go in the stage when we go green. Ethan O'Connor, Justin Ricci, and General Jake on two tires. Can they hold off the field?
It's possible. I mean, if they play the dirty air to their advantage, like we saw the 62 and the 1 doing earlier on in this race, I think it's definitely possible. Also, I'd like to apologize. I forgot we don't do double file restarts soon.
Well, I mean, we are kind of doing double file restarts.
Yeah, well, two. I said Bishop would be on the outside, and he technically is. He's, but I thought it was like outside as opposed to Jake.
You're not wrong, but as we take the green flag.
Look at Jones trying to get the high line from Caden, but he shuts the door.
They're all. Even in the turn one, Tanner with a huge run in turn three. Turn two.
See back here, 3-4 wide almost.
Here comes Tanner to the inside of Ricci.
Points, Carter sends it in, Kylie sends it in, Dover sending it in. This is going to be a wreck. This is going to be a freaking wreck.
There goes the 42 up the track, out of stage points already. White flag in the stage, side by side, O'Connor and Campos. Campos to the lead, not even a contest.
Oh my lord, and Carter Jones gonna try to go for the stage points as well.
And spinner Ricci! Ricci spins, harmless spin, into the apron, a turn in the backstretch, but no caution yet. Caution comes out!
Side by side.
To the stage win, it's Campos!
The battle, oh my god.
The battle of teammates. God, I love stage racing.
Man, I do too. That was the best thing I've seen in a long while. That was incredible. 2-3 wide. I thought we were going to see a massive, massive wreck, but in the end, it was just Ricci taking the spin. Unfortunate for him after avoiding that wreck, but Tanner Campos with the incredible win over Carter Jones in stage two.
Campos has now won 4 of the last 5 stages. This dude. This dude is finding some life when he needed it the most. We take a look here at the wreck.
And Ricci tangling. I mean, there's just so much going on. Going for those stage points. Off turn two, it was just an entire wad of cars and helped keep it off of one another. It just looked like they got hooked right there.
Smoke. There was a big wreck. Oh. Here's what. Before we get to that, here's the 11. I think he just tried to carry too much speed there and got into the 12.
Back to the restarts is just Davidson.
Oh, Tyler King. Oh my God.
Oh my
and
Lord.
And there's the big wreck. Holy crap.
Head on into the wall by someone. That looks vicious. We have a lot of, a lot to dissect back here.
So here is the second accident. Raven here on the apron just comes back up into the field. Oh my God, Kayla Marinelli.
Ooh. The hard hit was by a blue car. I can't tell who that is. Blue and white.
Benjamin Deloney.
Benjamin and JD got caught up in that. Oh my God.
Massive, massive accident. Here's how it unfolded from Raven's perspective. So you see, here's a huge stack up, and he's like, oh, look, there's no caution. I'm going to get some points. And he just completely sent it too hard.
Marinelli up on his side briefly almost. Climbed the wall a bit.
Here it is from the 15. He's stuck on the outside, so he can't go after any points. But he's doing everything right, doing everything right, and then...
Bring it home and no...
Oh! Oh!
Correct.
That got us a few DNFs, so the big wreck that you thought was going to happen, Cater, it actually did.
Yeah. I mean, really unfortunate for a lot of those guys. Maybe it was probably for the better that Ricci spun to the inside, because now he's able to continue with no significant damage as opposed to everyone else. Marinelli, Deloney, Bregler, Young, bunch of, not heavy hitters, but people I thought could have contended eventually later on in this race. And once again, another just misfortune to add on top of everything that's happened to him this season. It's unfortunate.
JD really did not need that. He needed a good run, and he was sort of getting it. He was running 12th, which was not great, but it was gonna do the job. Especially given the history of Chicagoland, knowing that there are big crashes like that, and he was caught up in the first one of them.
What that does, though, is spells good news for people like Roberto Crown, Colin Dover, just above that cutoff. Colin Dover having great points there right now, sitting in third, got a decent amount of stage points so far. Now. Some of the contenders he's contending against on the points cut just got taken out. So he's looking good for the 27 camp, as well as I'm not sure where Roberto is. Roberto's still in the race, right?
Yeah, he's in the Great Clips car this weekend. That car's running pretty terrible, but he survived the wreck.
Terrible enough to the point he was able to slow down and avoid the wreck, so... I mean, that's a plus. When you got a slow car, you have time to dodge a big accident like that one.
Green flag is back in the air with Campos out front. All right, final stage. They're already getting a lot more aggressive.
I can get much more aggressive than the last restart for those stage points. Now we got 50 laps to go in this race.
You're seeing a lot of new names up front. Here's Patrick Roden after getting involved in that accident between Nelson and JD Bregler. He's running top five right now, right behind his teammate.
Yeah, I don't know how Roden's up here right now, but good for Roden.
Sliding up is Colin Dover. Campos holds off his teammate. Campos. Campos on that top seam. Carter all the way to the bottom. No gain by either one. A slight loss to the 62. Campos running a half lane higher.
I mean, with what we've seen this race, I don't expect the leader to pull away much. We haven't really seen an advantage of greater than a second with how the dirty airs were, or not just dirty air, but like the draft. And then when you get to trying to pass the guy, it's incredibly difficult because of the dirty air.
Here's Caden Bishop going after a position on Brandon Allen. Caden, in the midst of that craziness, got shuffled back to eighth for stage two. But he's working his way back up there, now racing Brandon Allen for sixth. Although he's going to have to deal with Davidson. How about Patrick Roden? This guy made the playoffs in season one. He was on track to make the round of 12 until an untimely accident at Denver. And had he made that round of 12, he would have made the final four. The run he put on at the end of the year was absolutely fantastic, as we see a battle for the lead now developing between the 62 and the 00.
Patrick Roden is honestly a sleeper. I mean, he's good when you least expect it. He's won so many Daytona races. He's very talented. Currently 20th in the standings. Needs a good day to get himself comfortably into the battle. And with the incidents involving Ravid Dagan and JD Bregler, that's going to allow him to close the gap and playoff talk.
Roden just needs another chance. Campos continues to hold off the 62. Colin Dover now is going to be a bit preoccupied with the 04, who has found his speed again.
Yeah, both these two right now trying to find a way back up. They both fell off. More so Big G than Colin Dover, but now look at these two. I'm telling you, Dover with the speed, Big G somehow must have made adjustments to this race car because it is flying right now. However, if they stay side by side, it's going to allow these two Hose Mad Motorsports vehicles to pull away.
And I think Carter might seize that, and he's specifically not making a move on Tanner because of that. He knows if he can just push Tanner out far enough, it'll eventually be just between those two cars, and it'll be a guaranteed team victory. Three wide.
No guarantees, though, here at Chicago. I mean, with the racing we've seen, the close action, we've seen a couple incidents already today. You always can't bank on it going green, but definitely the play for what they're being given right now is try to get away from that 27 and 04 car and try to guarantee a team victory.
Look at this gaggle fighting for fifth place. That is 7, 8, 9, 10 cars under a blanket going for positions.
Continuing to ride in the 8th spot. I know Cade would love to get his victory today. December 8th is coming up pretty quickly. That's a very significant day to him. And for him to get a win today would mean a lot to him. It'd be his third win of the season. Looking like it's not going to happen unless he gets another caution and has a magical restart to get up and out of this dirty air.
How about the two guys behind Caden, though? The 6 of Justin Newman and the 94 of Logan Speed. Justin Newman was strong here at Chicago last year, so we know he knows his way around this track, but with this disappointing season that the Six has had, I'm pretty sure this almost feels like winning a race to him right now.
I mean, Justin Newman wants to win championship, but you have to take a step back, you know, you just have to find the speed in your car, start putting together the consistent runs, and right now this is a good step forward for the 16. And the 94, just such a heartbreak at Phoenix. I vividly remember calling that one with you, Zachary, and that race, let me tell you, bigger heartbreaks than racing for so many miles, so many laps, just to come up literally a nose short. Just unbelievable how he lost that race to Kyler Scott.
Sixth place, Bishop and Brandon Allen. Looks like Caden Bishop's going to roll through Brandon for the spot. This is the best Brandon has looked in a long time. Didn't really get stage points for the 07, but this car has been kind of... We talked about him earlier, kind of just trying to adjust, but he has not had the same straight line speed this year that he had last season. He has made up for it in pretty much just raw tenacity. But today is a day where he has the speed and he is showing it.
It makes you wonder what he could do if he could get out of this dirty air. Perhaps front run. I mean, like you said, it looks like he's got the speed today. Up into the top 10, 7th place. Could get into the top 5 in not too long.
Look at Justin Newman
battling with the 94 of Logan Speed.
Logan Speed with an aggressive move through the middle. Patrick Roeder backed the hell out of that. Now Logan's going in the inside of Brandon Allen. Whoa, contact.
And Trey Schlasser Jr. near contact entering turn 1.
This has got to be the most fun Tree Slasher's had in a race in a while. This has got to be the most fun Ethan Farley's had in a while. They're both running up front, running competitively, running around good cars.
Patrick Roden as well. Although Roden has been falling back, unfortunately.
That car cannot possibly still be good. The fact that he even got to fifth to begin with is mind-blowing.
And blowing Newman looking for 7th on Brandon Allen.
Justin Newman wanting to win the race. Justin Newman wanting to win the championship. And he is getting one step closer, one spot closer as he hounds Brandon Allen.
Logan Speed hanging in there as well. Here comes the 6 to the inside. Looks as though... side by side, and look at that, Justin Newman up to P7.
I don't know what's going on with Brandon Allen, if he burned off his tires trying to get into the top 5, but he has fallen off considerably, where he was at one point even running down the 04 and the 27. Now he's fallen back to 3 seconds behind the leader. Now he's in 9th.
I'm not sure what's up there either. You see Tree Schlasser continuing to battle. Into the top 10 here.
These guys.
Two laps to go up.
These guys are having the time of their lives. Kylie Greider is now back here after running top 5 all day.
What's that? That's kind of a shocker. I mean, I think the pit cycle had a big factor in that. We saw Caden Bishop fall back to 8th as well, as you'd mentioned. Now he's made his way up to 6th. Kyler Scott, Ricci, and others.
Kylie cannot be happy right now. She knows she is faster than all 3
of
these
the
cars.
Inside.
Oh, into the wall. Kylie turns him. Around goes Tree Slasher Jr. That's going to bring out a caution, and we're going to re-rack him.
Coming from a mile away, he got to his inside. That air upset the 8 car, went into the wall, ran out of room, and then 3 wide contact, and around went Schlasser. I could see that coming 3 seconds before it happened, Zachary.
Slasher coming back to the line. Here's Tanner. Tanner was starting to pull away from Carter. He is not happy about that.
Half a second on Carter Jones. He has a lot of speed, but unfortunately, now we're going to have more pit stops most likely and another restart, which changes the entire game.
A good race. Here they come down pit road. Everyone is coming down. I sincerely doubt that the guys that pulled the strategy last time, I don't think they're going to try that again.
You never know, though. If they were intelligent, though, I don't think they would, so.
There's Tanner into his box. Carter, Big G, most of the field. I don't see anyone pulling off, so it doesn't look like anyone on the first half of pit road has tried something. There's Newman out.
It's a good opportunity for Caden Bishop. He's got that number one stall. Let's see how he comes out relative to everyone else.
Tanner Campos leads them off. Davidson, Urenda. Caden holds neutral. Comes out sixth. Tyler King starting to be relevant for the first time today. Contact! Chris Black, Dylan Jones.
And damage to the right side of the 48, unfortunately, and the front of Chris Black.
There's the lap cars. They'll probably be coming in next time by. Tanner retains the lead, but oh, now he's got Trevor Davidson behind him.
Well, this is going to be quite interesting.
Tanner and Trevor Davidson, noted rivals.
That's a very unexpected rivalry. Yeah, here's the replay.
Tree Slasher. Ooh, yeah, he gets up there, disturbs the dirty air. And then he just never is able to get away because I don't think he anticipated Roden in the wall.
Angle here. We're with Tree Slasher Jr. And see, right here, he's going to have the line to the middle. Gets right there to the A car. That either loses. I think he gets him a bit loose out of the groove, and then they just collide. I mean, yeah. I think most of the blame goes on Tree Schlasser for getting that A car upset in the first place and just triggering that whole ordeal.
But at the same time, that's a valid method of making a pass, so I think what Tree Slasher was really trying to do was take some momentum away from the 8 car, and it just ended up turning into something completely different from what he wanted.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, he was having a magical run today. It really sucks that it had to end like that, or at least he's going to be continuing on in this race, I think, with damage. But getting into the closing stages of the race, I don't blame him for trying to do that. But with how high up Patrick Roden was, I mean,
we're going to have 26 laps to go when we restart this race, and things are gonna get a little more intense.
They are, man. I love Chicago. I mean, it's amazing. Contenders from last year, front run. We've seen Tanner trying to get his season on the rails right now. Lots of unexpected contact and wrecks, especially with one of the lap cars you see right there, Nick Nelson.
Who do you think has the edge right now as far as who do you think is the favorite to win this race right now?
I mean, definitely Tanner Campos, but you can't take your eye off on Carter Jones either. Defending winner of Chicago, he was putting up a fight with Tanner, but actually lost ground to Tanner there. But on fresh tires, I think he's a bit better than the double zero. It's just a matter of seeing if he can get by these two that are now in front of him, that being Davidson and Urenda. But let's keep an eye out for what Trevor Davidson has. I really want to see what he has to put up against Tanner Campos right here as we head back to the restart zone.
Tanner Campos is going to lead a long line of late lead lap cars to the restart zone. Leon
Newman too, and Caden Bishop. I mean, they're both looking fast. We know Caden's fast. He's just mired back here in traffic.
Tanner with a pretty solid start. Davidson pulls away with him. Justin Ricci getting stuck behind the two of Brian Leon. There he goes to the bottom. Ricci having a very nice bounce back.
You're seeing a lot more impatience, almost pack racing, 2-3 wide, right on each other's doors and bumpers as they go through the trioval.
Brandon Allen capitalizes. He gains a lot of spots on the restart. Caden's slipping back on another restart. Man, for as aggressive as he is, he's normally not struggled on restarts, but today he's lost a ton of spots on these opening laps of a run.
It seems like he has a better long run car. Seems like the last he was leading earlier, he would start to lead after he's gotten some laps on the tires. Same goes for other guys. Actually, the opposite for Brandon Allen. I was about to say he's fallen off on the long runs, but right now looking great on the short run. It's now he's to the bumper. Caden is to Brandon.
Really tough racing. Here's Justin Newman going for fourth now. What are we at as far as like celebration in Justin Newman racing right now? Daytona 500 win?
Yeah, pretty much, I'd say. I mean, this team is performing so incredible right now. Just a matter of closing it out.
Justin Ricci up to 13th. This guy, 5.1 average finish, 4.5 average finish on intermediates now. You cannot shake him no matter how bad a car he has. And Davidson to the inside.
Then there, at least yet, Tanner Campos continues to hold him at bay. Yurenda up the third. Newman there in fourth still. Carter Jones running out the top five.
And these two are pulling away. Yurenda now trying to hold off Newman, who's going for third.
Theme to how the 00 and 62 pulled away last time. Now it's the 00 and 45 Geico machine of Trevor Davidson. And Trevor looking for his second win of the season. Good. Really great runs that 45's been putting together.
Caden Bishop now back in the top five, running fourth, and three wide for fifth. Yurenda, Jones, Brandon Allen.
Bishop has broken free. Watch this, because he is to the inside of Justin Newman. If he can get by, this one car might be the one to beat.
But he's got to get by him first, and it's been. And as these runs go on, it gets much, much harder to pass cars. Davidson finding that out right now, that you cannot just pass Tanner Campos.
Allen. Newman trying to keep him up to third.
Oh, is Brandon going to go three wide? That was the same move Tree pulled off, but Brandon backs off.
Once now, Newman was the fastest car on the racetrack, perhaps could catch the top two, but now he's starting to fall back a bit.
Now Brandon Allen to the inside, looking for fourth. Ethan Farley having a huge run to the outside. What a great run he's had so far.
Yeah, Farley, I mean, he's been as low as like what, maybe 20th, but now he's made his way up to 7th, looking for 6th on, no, he isn't 6th right now, actually looking for the top 5 spot on Brandon Allen right now,
and a gaggle of cars behind him follows him right into the turn. Brandon Allen trying to hold him off, 3 wide behind him.
Has had the speed throughout the race, fallen off a bit from where he was. He was up as high as third in this race. right now just trying to hold on to a top 10 position as he battles with Big G and others.
And this is the point in the run where, Ethan Farley, in the bumper!
Contact.
And he's not letting go! He's still in there! He's flipped! He's up and over! Huge contact made! Dylan Jones is in there. Oh, another more crashing. Ricci's out.
God,
Ethan O'Connor. Nick Nelson is in there. Brian Leon piles in. Raven Dakin stopped on track. It's Paul Donlin getting involved.
Oh my God, this changes everything.
Holy crap, a huge one.
Oh my God. I did not see that one coming. I really hope Ethan O'Connor's okay. That looked bad.
That was horrifying.
Ethan Farley hopefully is okay. He took a little tumble. He went into the wall and did a cool little flip. But I mean, I think he's all right. I get on O'Connor though. I really hope he's okay.
Nobody pits. Here's what happened.
That looks exactly like Mooch earlier in the race.
I don't know what Ethan Farley was thinking there. I'm going to be completely honest. Takes out...
Such a good run.
Takes out Kyler Scott and Dylan Jones and Brandon Allen. There's Sydney, Patrick, and Paul Donlin. Tyler King stopped. Ricci stopped. Kyler Scott, Urenda, O'Connor, Dagan, Leon, Garcia, Donlin.
Donlin got damage.
Huge damage. He's done. Toddy with massive damage. Here's what started the second wreck. Carter and Big G trying to avoid together, and they just come together.
Look at Roberto Crown miss that.
Hitting the roof by
the 11. Didn't look like a serious hit to the roof, but definitely hitting the roof of it.
That was tough. Sydney Allen with the big miss. Driving through the grass to get around it. Here it is from Tyler King, who had just gotten into contention.
Oh my God.
There's nowhere he can go. The 12 comes down in front of him. This is going to be Justin Ricci's first DNF of the season in a near unavoidable accident.
Sideways from a mile ahead and then just flipping all of a sudden. Right now, Kyler Scott's like, oh, damn, I don't know what to do. He had it avoided,
and then Dylan Jones came in from behind.
And look at this right here. Upside down right here. That was actually worse than I thought it was. Oh, Lord.
The data says he only hit him at about 95 miles an hour. So, Ethan has a chance, but that's still a rough hit. Oh, Dylan.
Is it speed, Zachary, or is it how fast Scott was going?
That's how fast Scott was going when he hit him.
We've seen lots of tough wrecks in MLCS, though, for being honest. I mean,
what
scares you the most, despite all the miraculous crashes everyone survived, what scares you the most is those roof impacts. We saw Tom Larson pass away at Phoenix from a roof hit. Now, Ethan O'Connor, we worry for him as he's been nailed in the roof.
We saw Dylan Jones get injured from a roof hit at Bristol last year. Oh, and he gets drilled by Farley.
Oh. Happened to a guy like Ethan O'Connor. Such a nice guy, passionate driver.
No one worse that could happen to. Really a great young driver with a lot of potential. One of the better road racers that we've had. Hoping he's okay. No updates yet.
Really hoping he's okay. I mean, couple updates for you later on, though. Maybe. Stay tuned for post-race is what that means, by the way.
Yeah. But definitely stay tuned to the end of this race, because somebody who was not involved in that wreck is the double zero of Tanner Campos, and he has been lights out ever since he got the lead.
Shifting gears from that wreck, we got to remember this is a very exciting, heated battle between two rivals of Tanner Campos and Trevor Davidson to close out here at Chicago today. And then Caden Bishop in third, and a very hungry Justin Newman right there in the Tampa Bay Lightning car. He's fourth.
Here we go. Green flag in the air. We're underway, and Tanner with not that great a restart. Davidson right there on his bumper.
Cars are left in this race. Half the field has been demolished from that accident.
Okay, KR with an issue. That car's slow on the track.
Hopefully he's able to get it out of harm's way.
He's going to try to keep running. See what it sounds like when it comes down, when it comes around. That thing is sick. It's sick. It's running low. It's down. It's got to be down a cylinder.
Fortunate, but at least he made all those passes on everyone that was involved in that wreck. So it should be decent points for KR nonetheless. As you see here, Davidson trying different lines to get around Tanner Campos. Went low. Now going high.
To high. Tanner's got a block.
Crossover.
Tanner gets in front of him just in time to prevent the air from being an advantage. Here's Davidson. The one of Caden Bishop right behind him. Caden to the inside.
This would be big for Caden Bishop.
Not able to.
Even bigger for Tanner Campos, though.
Not big enough. Caution!
Oh.
We're gonna have another one. Demo Redneck. Oh, that's Sydney. Oh.
Fortunate. You hate to see Sydney in a wreck. Here's Demo. Let's see how this.
Oh my.
Once again, same deal with like Seth and that other dude earlier in the race.
Alan Mooch.
Yeah, Alan Mooch.
That other dude.
I remembered his name 10 minutes ago when I brought it up then. I just forgot about it this time, apparently. That's how my brain works. Here's a look at this onboard. Oh, my God.
No idea. There must be something about that turn that's just deceptive like that. Because that's three different drivers that have made the same mistake. And it's not just them. Those are just the only three that caused incidents. We've seen it a bunch of times where there's guys just making contact in that corner.
Yeah, I think you're right. I mean, sometimes be deceptive. That's all there is to that statement.
It's got just the way the car loads, the way they go down into the turn, the way the blind spots end up working out. Something has got to be making it hard to tell if you're clear or not. Something's got to be leading these guys to believe.
Going 200 miles per hour, you know.
Yeah, I think that might have something to do with it. Plus, it's the end of the race. You're being aggressive. So we're gonna have a restart with about 5 laps to go. Tanner Campos, Trevor Davidson, Caden Bishop, Justin Newman, Logan Speed, Kylie Greider, who's fought her way back into the top 10 in this. Carter Jones, Roberto Crown Jr. is going to, after being terrible all day, is going to get a great result. Chris Black is now up here for the first time. Same story with him. And Tree Slasser has worked his way back into the top 10.
Went from great day to not good day to good day again. So great for Tree Slasher Jr. Also great for Roberto Crown Jr., like you mentioned. I mean, with all these guys being taken out, that just helps Roberto above the cut line that much more. And Hampus up front, he's got a lot of points to his benefit right now. 77 entering this race. I mean, that doesn't really hurt if he wins. So
Tanner right now, this would be the earliest in the season that Tanner has won at the cup level. Last season, it took him until the regular season finale to finally get one, where he ended up also winning the regular season championship. This would be a much earlier one, and it would, and as things stand right now, it would put him around third in points. Still well back of Ricci, but all runs start somewhere.
Yes, they do. I have to go here under the caution. So it looks like we might have a four-lap shootout if I were to guess.
Yeah, definitely. We're gonna go green next time by. So yeah, lights out on the pace car. We're gonna have a four-lap shootout. What can Trevor Davidson do to beat Tanner Campos here? Because Tanner is pretty immaculate on restarts. It's going to be pretty hard to pass him there.
Well, I was watching these two battle last restart. I think if for there to be any chance for Trevor Davidson, he's got to utilize the middle to high line. That seemed like the only speed he could get and the run he could get on Tanner is trying to form a run off the corner and then cross over on the straightaway. Then get the advantage entering the corner. Try and clear him entering it. So I think that's probably the 45's best bet. But on top of that, he's got to manage the 1 and the 6 behind him. Those two have been very fast today. So, I mean, a lot on Trevor Davidson's plate right now. But then again, a lot on Tanner Campos's plate as well. It depends who's going to crack under pressure.
It's just a lot on everyone's plate right now. Campos has 10 fast cars behind him to defend. Trevor Davidson and Caden Bishop have to negotiate playing both offense and defense, and everyone behind them has a lot of cars to pass in four laps. Here they come, pace car, pulling off pit road. Tanner Campos gets away. What a great restart by the 00.
Or hurts him, because these guys now have drafting help with each other. See if they can close back in on the 00, perhaps get a run.
Three wide for fifth place. Logan Speed up top. Kylie Greider, Carter Jones to the bottom. Here comes Caden. Oh, this is looking like Giancarlo's restart. They're coming back to Tanner.
Yeah, Davidson retains second, and they are coming back to Tanner, but Caden is being kind of stubborn as he goes to the inside. He does not want to help these guys. He just wants to go for it himself.
That's what you get with Caden. Here he goes to the inside again.
And they are all over Tanner. Tanner's going to have to do some blocking if he wants to win this race, I think.
Here they two to go.
This Newman and Caden trying to make something happen on the high line. Caden went a lane higher than Justin Newman. That was a bit awkward right there.
Not a great exit for either. Coming to the white flag this time by Davidson right on the bumper.
Right,
he's got some clean
air.
Half
a line.
White flag in the air. One more time around for Campos. Davidson
once again high.
Pokes Caden high to the outside. He's going to be there. Drag race down the backstretch. Campos. Bishop.
Campos.
He's got to drive it in deep here. He does. Tanner Campos is going to be clear. Tanner
he
Campos.
Got it.
Charlotte was the one that got away. Chicago's the one that came to him. Campos wins at Chicago.
All right. Woo. Tanner. Woo.
Tanner Campos with the bounce back. What a heartbreak at Charlotte. Comes back the very next race and wins. What a drive. Tanner coming around turn three. Gator,
where are you going? Oh no.
I think he's having a diarrhea attack. That's not good. But here's Tanner Campos. What a story. Dude dominated last week at Charlotte, led 116 laps. And he got robbed by a wreck that was completely out of his control. Nothing he could do to avoid it. And he comes back the next week, brings the same speed, and he wins at Chicagoland. What a big turnaround for this team after kind of floundering for much in the early part of the season. Now they've got a win earlier than they ever have. In the first time he's ever won in a non-Exalta car. Gotta bode well for this team in the future. Tanner Campos bringing it down on top of us. I think they're delivering the flag to him. Yep, there he has the flag. He's going to head to victory lane right there. Very, very popular win for the MLNCS most popular driver, Tanner Campos. Thank you for tuning in today. hope you had fun. Post-race coverage continues in the MLNCS garage. I'm going to go figure out what the hell happened to Gator Johns.
Song.
me. Take me. I ain't no fortunata. I ain't no fortunata. I ain't no fortunate. Son.